Hello friends, I am Dr. K.C. Jain and we are discussing about laser, and it is the second lecture of laser, and in which we will discuss the condition of laser, or we can say the principle of lasers. Principle of laser. There are three conditions we can say. There are three main principles, principle for laser, of laser, and one by one we will discuss these three conditions. The first condition, for the first condition, that is, we can say A, and we will write for that the probability of, we will calculate the probability of spontaneous emission divided by probability of stimulated emission, that probability of spontaneous divided by probability of stimulated emission. This probability of spontaneous emission, the number of atoms is n1 spontaneous n2, and it will depend upon the parameter, that is a21. Now the probability of stimulated emission, that is n2 b21 u nu, just now we have seen there in the next previous lecture. So this n2 n2 is cancelled, and p spontaneous divided by p stimulated is equals to a21 upon b21 u nu. We can write it as on substituting value of u nu from the previous lecture, from previous lecture or from equation 1. This is equation 1 that we have discussed in last lecture. This is equation 1. So we can substitute the value of u nu from here, and this u nu or p spontaneous divided by p stimulated will be equal to a21 upon b21, and in place of u nu we can write a21 upon b21, and the denominator term will be in the numerator, and here it will be e to the power h nu upon kbt b12 upon b21 minus 1. So this term is cancelled out, and p spontaneous divided by p stimulated, we have e to the power h nu upon kbt b12 upon b21 minus 1. From the relation between Einstein's coefficient, b12 is equals to b21. Hence, p spontaneous divided by p stimulated is equal to e to the power h nu upon kbt minus 1. And so we can write p spontaneous divided by p stimulated is e to the power h nu upon kbt minus 1. This e to the power h nu upon kbt is number of atoms in ground state and excited state. So p spontaneous divided by p stimulated is equals to n1 upon n2 minus 1. Or p spontaneous upon p stimulated, approximately we can write n1 upon n2. Normally, what n1 upon n2? Generally, we can discuss from this equation or this equation. So if we take this equation, then at normal temperature, h nu is always much higher than kbt. So if h nu is much higher than kbt, then this value of e will be high, and the e to the power h nu upon kbt will be much higher than 1, or the probability of spontaneous emission or probability of stimulated emission will be much higher than 1, or the probability of spontaneous emission will be much higher than probability of stimulated emission, and it is not as per our expectation. what expectation we have, that probability of stimulated emission must be high than the probability of spontaneous emission. So again we can write, to get laser, what we have to do, to get laser, the h nu must be less than kbt. H nu must be less than kbt. So in that case, e to the power h nu upon kbt will be much much less than 1, or probability of spontaneous emission divided by probability of stimulated emission will be much much less than 1, or we can say the probability of spontaneous emission will be much much probability of stimulated emission. Or if we substitute the value, that probability of spontaneous emission is always a n2 a21 divided by probability of stimulated emission n2 b21 u nu, n2 n2 is cancelled, it is less than 1. So it is the condition that a21 upon b21 u nu must be less than 1, and it is the, we can say, the first condition of laser or first principle of laser, or the probability of spontaneous emission is always less than the probability of stimulated emission. It is the first condition of laser. Now we will derive in again another lecture the second and third condition.